can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Well, my goodness gracious, let me tell you the news. My head's been wet with the midnight dew. I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee. He spoke to me with a voice so sweet, I thought I heard the shuffle of angels sweet. He called my name and my heart stood still when he said, John, go do my will. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Well, you may throw your rock, hide your hand, working in the dark against your fellow man, but as sure as God made black and white, what's done in the dark will be brought to the light. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.
When river fishing, I find, you know, the current plus the fact that there's a lot of boulders and rocks down below. I love fishing my Senkos or any of my baits, really. I Texas rig them rather than Wacky rig them. In order to Texas rig a bait, basically all you're going to do is you're going to take your bait or your worm, you're going to put a little hole in there, if you can see, and then bring it right back out. And you're going to slip that worm all the way up to the top of the offset. Okay, so this is the way it should look now at the top of the offset. Then you just kind of find the point of the hook at where, you know, it'll be fished relatively straight. Just put your fingers there and slide it through and up. Okay, and then now you just have a little bit of room and you're just going to stick in that point just on the very tip. And that way you have a pretty smooth and straight presentation with your worm. And when the fish does take this worm, actually what will happen is this point will slide out. Usually the Senko slides all the way up the hook, but that hook will just sit right in the lip of the fish. And that's a great way to fish it, so you can fish that Senko weedless. So that's the way I fish it, and that's actually what I caught a lot of those small little bass on. This is Mike Petrella, and we'll see you next time.